This past weekend, the Chinese capital hosted the 2013 Job Fair for Foreigners, a day-long recruitment drive put together since 2005 by the China International Talent Network and the State Administration of Foreign Expert Affairs. Our reporter Aidan Barua has more.
This here is the 24th such fair, with previous hosting cities including Shanghai and Tianjin, among others, and with employers from a dozen provinces, including over 500 jobs. But apparently it's not just the host cities or number of jobs on offer which have been changing over the last 8 years or so.
Employers have evolved from purely education-focused sectors to a wide range of industries, including construction, sales, healthcare, consultancy, engineering, and even designing. At the same time, candidates or job seekers are increasingly looking to join in the industry of their own specialty or educational background, and not just English language training. Employers have also raised their requirements. For instance, some firms now require several years of work experience, especially with overseas multinationals. This is largely in line with the improved expertise of job seekers. Our statistics show that 85% of the candidates participating in the fair have found an ideal job, although whether they stay with the firm or not depends on individual circumstances.
And those individual circumstances would presumably depend on, well, the individuals themselves. So we spoke to a few of those attending as potential candidates and possibly future employees.
So we're at the Swiss Hotel for the International Job Fair, and I've got with me Ryan and Sunny. I'll start with you, Ryan. What are you looking for in this job fair? What sort of industries are you looking at? Are you looking to change industries? What are your overall expectations here?
Well, basically, I'm just kind of putting my feet in the water, seeing what I have available for myself. I'm a teacher, so it's not terribly complicated to look for a job, but I just wanted to take a look and see what other opportunities I have. Right now I teach English, but I'm interested in moving on and possibly teaching an international school and maybe different subjects.
Predominantly, I'm looking in the same industry, which is education. My goal is to find something in an education administration or in human resources. In the past, I've worked as a recruiter for foreign teachers and kind of helping the foreign teachers navigate their new job and their new living environment. In fact, Ryan is one of the teachers I actually recruited to China to work as a teacher. And so I'm kind of looking mostly in that area, but since I've been in China for a while, I'm keeping my options open.
From what I've seen so far is educated focused, so a lot of jobs in the education field. So I have met a lot of capable people, so it definitely has been interesting. However, I feel it's been strictly within that field, so it's been a little bit different for what I expected previously.
We can get to know many people. We can get many contacts where we can contact them later on. So it's a good platform to get many opportunities. I think surfing on net is different thing, but meeting people and interacting with them makes you more confident.
With the visiting foreign talent numbering in the thousands, from not just North America and Europe, but the rest of Asia, South America, and even Africa, the scope for contact may well continue beyond this day. The vacancies will continue to be advertised beyond the day-long fair, still available on the China International Talent website, until, of course, they get filled. This is Aidan Barua in Beijing for BON.